We're about to start. If you have your cell phones on, turn them off!
Hello, friends. Are you here for the meeting?
It's the first Sandown has ever had. It's quite the occasion. Everyone who's anyone is here.
No? You've never been to Sandown?
Well, it grows on you. And there's a lot to see here, lots of trees and flowers. We're small about everything here. Small town, small buildings, small people. But America being on its own now, it's a whole new venture. And some of the men here in town thought that it would be good to establish ourselves sooner rather than later. So here we are. May I introduce you to some of the bigwigs in town? Right over here, Mr. Jonathan Straw, one of our newly elected selectmen. Perfect for the job, knows everyone in town, and hasn't been in a quarrel with anyone since his school days, friendly with absolutely everyone. And over here, Mr. Phineas Whittier. I've known him since I was a schoolboy. He's a strong willed one, and he's a selectman running for state representative. Oh, and up there, that's Captain Demon. No one really knows his first name. We just call him Captain, which is entirely appropriate if you ask me. He's came to us from the big cities and has sat in on big state meetings. Perfect to moderate the first town meeting. Oh, it looks like we're about to start. How exciting.
Welcome, welcome to all. I call to session the first townwide meeting of the town of Sandown in the state of New Hampshire on this fifth day of March, 1790. Does the town concede to the recording of the minutes?
This is where you're supposed to say yes.
Yes!
Terribly sorry, Captain. This is a whole new battlefield. Voting in our first town meeting and stumbling at the starting line.
Not to worry, Mr. Straw. Just don't say anything you don't want in the record. The same goes for you too, Mr. Bennett.
That's Spencer Bennett. He's also running for state representative. But he's a troublemaker. He once drove a wagon into Angle Pond and convinced everyone in town that it was a vagrant passing through. Imagine how he would fare in the Senate.
All right. Let's get down to business now, folks. Our first order is to vote for the funding of the new school. The committee's proposal is 61 pence, zero farthings for the current swing year. An annual budget will call. We're now open the floor for debate.
It seems a fair amount. The open meeting pays for 11 students you write on. They need a school as well. Have you forgotten with no place to put the children?
Why don't we put them in Mrs. Straw's basement? She can teach them there.
Hardly sufficient, Mr. Bennett.
Enough of you, Spencer. Mrs. Straw, could you suggest a more suitable solution to this problem?
Well, I do.
That's Adelaide Demon. The daughter of the captain. She just returned to us a few months ago from a boarding school in England. And ever since then, she's been teaching here in Sandown.
Please state your name and occupation.
Adelaide Demon. I teach at Mrs. Straw, and I say no children could possibly learn with just a notebook and a pencil at their disposal.
Proceed, Mrs. Demon.
A child's mind is undeveloped. It needs nurturing. We as educators need the proper place and materials to foster children's growth. Maps, book, chalk, it's all necessary. A budget of 61 pence would hardly finance a single piece of paper.
Miss Demon, we can't simply throw all our money away on a school. It wouldn't be prudent to cost them all the town's time.
But she's right, our children deserve a good education. It's not a question of money, friends. It's a question of whether you want this town to have a future or not. A school assures that we leave this town in good hands when we leave.
Is there a motion to expand the school budget?
There is. I make a motion to expand the budget to 81 pence, zero farthings.
Does anyone second that motion?
I second that motion, Captain.
Abstentions? None? Then the motion is passed. The new school budget is 81 pence, zero farthings. Annual budget will be determined at a later date. Moving on, now we have the highways that go through town. Our roads are in deplorable condition. Our horses are breaking their legs. We've had many complaints. Spencer, do you want to speak on this subject?
I do, Captain, and I thank you much.
as you all know, I live just down the road from this meeting house here. And I can't even drive my carriage from the meeting house to my own home. I recently bought a new carriage, a very expensive one. And I wish to be able to drive it throughout Sandown, but I cannot because of the condition of the roads.
I agree, Mr. Bennett. Many of us are unable to use the road for fear of damage it may cause our vehicles.
But how will we pay for these road repairs, and how much will it cost?
I have to figure someplace. 90 pence and 6 farthings. Everyone sit down. One person at a time will speak, please.
It's simply too much. The town cannot risk sacrificing that much of the budget. Perhaps we could expand the construction over the next several years.
No, it's imperative that we fix all the roads in town immediately. I need to be able to...
Just note it, please.
Ah, yes.
Any final nominations?
I nominate Samuel Sandborn. His intellect far outweighs any other in this town. And he listens. And when he speaks, he's heard. Fine qualities for a statesman.
Odd. Samuel never formally announced his candidacy. And he's only 22, a mere toddler. His running mates won't take this sitting down. I fear there could be a brawl.
Samuel Sandborn? What an absurd notion! He's a boy! He spends all his time playing in my fields. It's preposterous.
It should be no matter if he is right for the task at hand. He's quick, he's level-headed, and
what of experience? What a worldly knowledge. The boy has barely stepped outside his door.
Nor have you, Phineas. I suggest you sit down and close your mouth before it gets the better of you. Sam is as fit as any of us. He just happens to have a fine education, has a good head on his shoulders. Seems like a good choice to me.
You would, Bennett. Your judgment of his father is a rainy day. He is too young and too naive about the issues at hand. An unwise candidate to be sent to the capital to represent Sandown. We're small enough as it is. We don't need further belittlement by whisking an unfit representative off the state house.
It is not we you speak of, Phineas. It's your own insecurities about the new government. Perhaps he is too young, but his ideas are new and influenced entirely by democracy. He could be an asset to the Senate. Who are we to deny them of such a treasure?
Phineas has some more to his worry. Samuel is quite young, and Concord is a very big place. And he shall go to the National Assemblies in Pennsylvania and Massachusetts. How will he fare then? It is not his character we question. It's his ability to maintain his composure, a skill learned with time and practice, something Samuel may not have attained as yet.
Pardon me, but I would like to say...
It is for the people of the town to decide, not just old men stuck in their old ways.
Now see here, young man. We old men know a thing or two about running a government.
Now, how do you explain the war against the Redcoats? A fluke?
Why, you, that was a valiant fight that we won. If I can remind you, and it wasn't for you to bring up that. While we were fighting, you were sitting at home picking your nose, defecating yourself on the hour.
Judge of my consistent bowel movements, are we now, Phineas?
Pardon me, but I'd like to say something on my behalf. Oh, dear.
Bless your lungs, Samuel. Please take the floor.
Thank you, sir. And thank you, Jonathan Straw, for your kind words. And I do accept the nomination.
Did you get that, Ezra?
Well, couldn't I? I'm screaming.
I understand your concerns, Phineas. I am young and I'm quite naive. I have never been out of these state borders, nor have I ever seen a state proceeding or governed a town. But I have studied the laws of the world. I can tell you about the governments of Rome, as well as the years that shaped French monarchy. I can even describe to you about the tyranny of Rome's dominion. I wish I could calm your fears, but all I can do is offer you the love I have for this country and this town. And I would ask you all to trust me, representatives and Congress. Thank you.
That's the most I think I've ever heard Samuel Sanborn say at one time. And this is quite an occasion. I bet you're all excited that you stayed. Well, I guess it wasn't much of a show, but it means a lot to the folks around here.
That's very nice and all, Samuel. But how can we trust that you'll make true to us when you reach the Senate? Will you become another puppet for another senator?
I will not turn into a puppet for a Senate, nor into any older senator. I have always remained true to my beliefs. When have you known me to stray away from something that was somehow dishonest or immoral? I've been here for the past 22 years, through every tribulation that we have gone through. And you feel as though my age disqualifies me to run? I am shocked and appalled. And for that, it taints my soul to even hear such a thing.
Again, Samuel amazes me by his determination for his spot in the Senate. And he seems to have impressed the captain, which may earn him the position. The men in this town look to the captain for leadership. And this might even sway the tides of the vote.
Well spoken, Samuel. Even though you are young and speak with more intelligence than most of the men that I served with, I believe that you deserve the respect of everyone in this town, myself included. I believe now that we've heard from everyone, is there anyone else that wants to speak? No, then let us commence with the voting. Please raise your hand for the man that you'd like to see be the number one person in our Senate. Everyone may vote, including women.
Everyone here is invited to vote with us today to see who will go to the Senate.
First vote, all for Jonathan Straw. Raise your hand. Phineas Whittier. Spencer Bennett. Samuel Sandborn. Angela, who is the first chair of the Senate?
Jonathan Straw is our first chair.
Excellent. You can see me afterwards about your duties. I will tell you what you need to do. Now let's proceed with our second candidate. Again, everyone may vote. All those in favor of Phineas Whittier. Spencer Bennett. Samuel Sanborn. Ezra, who does the second seat go to?
I never expected this, but it goes to Samuel Sanborn.
I believe both men will do an outstanding job, and I commend you, the town of Sandown, for electing these two men. Before we adjourn, I'd like to ask all members if this meeting was beneficial to all.
I believe it was, Captain.
We need to revise how this is going to work for next time, but I believe in general that having the townspeople involved in making the decisions as opposed to just the selectmen, whom I never really trusted, is a good thing.
Involved with our town, and this meeting really helped me understand what we're all doing.
Ezra, did you get all that?
Yep, that's right, Captain.
Good. Then is there a motion to adjourn?
I make a motion, Captain.
And a second?
I second the motion.
Motion passed. Next meeting will be the 5th of August in the year of our Lord, 1790.
Thank you all for coming to this meeting. It was very exciting and tempers flared up, but that happens in a town like this. Still, I think that we all worked very well together. And I'm excited to see what Jonathan and Samuel will do in the Senate later this month. Well, I hope you all come back and visit Sandown again sometime soon. I'm sure that many great things and people are yet to come.
Thank you. contest. Oh, come on.
There you go, yeah.
Thank you.